Hi, I'm Dr. Dhanvanti Rajwade, and you are watching Anatomy of Bias.
So this is a case of a 20-year-old person who was born into the female sex and was assigned as the female gender at birth. And at a very young age, this person started feeling that they are more inclined towards, you know, masculine gender roles and gender appearances. As they were growing up, they would prefer to wear boys' clothes or play with toys, which are traditionally, you know, given to boys, like guns and cars. Would hang out with more boys from the peer group rather than girls. And parents also didn't really mind much, thinking that, you know, it's just a kid who's just experimenting with things or just being a little different. As they grew older, puberty hit, their body started changing, and that's when they started feeling very, very uncomfortable with their body because it was not matching their identity, the way they perceived themselves. They wanted to look, you know, masculine and be addressed like a boy, be addressed like a man, but their body wasn't cooperating. The society was also, you know, treating them like a female. So around 17 years of age, they confided about their feelings and their experience into a friend. And this friend helped them, you know, look up what exactly is going on the internet. There's a lot of information available there. And they came to know that this is something called as gender dysphoria, formerly also called as GID or gender identity disorder. And there is an option of medical transition where you can actually change your body to align with your psychological gender. So that's when they decided they want to do it. But of course, it was very difficult, you know, to really talk about this with their parents because it's something so different, something so new. Then, of course, they came out to their parents and said that, you know, this is how they feel, because they were at a crucial point actually in their life when they had to move to a college. After finishing their 12th standard, they wanted to go for graduation, and they wanted to go to the college to a new place as their true self. So they thought that, you know, we'll take a gap in education if need be, but I would like to, you know, just go to the college as who I am. So with the medical transition in progress. So that's the time that they chose to come out to the parents.
Okay. What was the bias experienced by the patient at that point of time from the parents as well as extended family and friends?
Yeah. So, of course, usually parents react with a lot of shock and denial when, you know, patients come out to them about their gender identity, which is different from their assigned sex. And this reaction was no different. And, you know, the denial, usually when parents are in denial, they say things like, this is a phase, or you're just imagining it, or you're just feeling this. You must try to just dress up like a girl, just try to behave like a girl. In fact, some of their peers even suggested that, why don't you go out with boys? Why don't you experience heterosexual relationships to feel more like a girl? So a lot of these bizarre solutions were, you know, thrown their way. Yeah. And it was, of course, very, very uncomfortable for them, because this is exactly something that they don't want. And this is what they were being forced to do. So, yeah, so that was a pretty tough phase for the patient. With time, the parents did come to terms to this idea that, okay, something is going on with their child and it's not just going to go away. But unfortunately, instead of going to the right professional to understand what's going on, they went to somebody who would, you know, sort of reinforce their denial. So they went to a doctor. Apparently, I checked out the credentials later and turned out that it was not a medical professional. It was not a licensed medical professional. But this person guaranteed that they would help in changing the mind of their kid. This would, you know, this person guaranteed that for X amount of money and X amount of time, they will make the child think and behave like a woman, like a girl. This is traditionally known as conversion therapy. It's something which is absolutely unscientific and puts families and patients through a lot of trauma.
So here was a set of parents who were in denial that they were even willing to resort to an unproven and possibly harmful technique called conversion therapy. Okay.
Absolutely. 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 They were very, insistent upon keeping their image of their child rather than seeing what exactly their child is. So after months of going to that person and enduring a lot of emotional trauma and conflict back at home, they realized that this is not really working out, and they thankfully stopped going there. And the patient themselves found out about me through their references. They connected with me to understand what's going on and what can be done about it, and mostly to help their parents understand that this is what it is and this is what needs to be done. And we involved the parents in the treatment process. I took a few sessions of counseling the parents, educating them about what it is. They calmed down after a bit, after 2-3 sessions. And then finally, we did the psychiatric evaluation that's needed for gender dysphoria. We proceeded with the transition process. So today the patient has completed, almost 6 months of HRT, hormone replacement therapy, and they're very, very happy with the result, and they're contemplating surgeries to, further align their gender. Another thing about this particular case was that the patient's life was on hold because of this condition. Because it's very important for a person to be, seen as who they are among their peers, where they're working, where they're studying. And this patient had made actually a very wise decision of transitioning before they enter college. Even at that young age, it was a very wise decision, because transitioning through college would have put an additional stress of adjustment. But because of this societal bias that the parents were also a victim of, this process got a little delayed. And their education also suffered a bit because of that.
And Dr. Pandey, as we know, this is not a sudden change that happens. It happens very gradually, the medical transition. So throughout that phase, I'm sure your patient must have experienced bias at several different levels, from not only from society, but possibly even from medical professionals, paramedical staff. So how did you help them through that, and how did that impact the person's morale?
Yeah, of course. So unfortunately, not many people are aware of, gender dysphoria as a condition, and how we should approach, even as healthcare workers, a person who presents with gender dysphoria. We often end up, misgendering them. We use their pronouns, which are more according to their sex rather than their gender. We use names which, again, create that dysphoria in them, which are more aligned with their sex rather than their gender. So at each point, basically, the patient has to face a lot of discomfort. I mean, it would be the same kind of discomfort that you and yes. I would have to face if we were misgendered, if we were called by a name that doesn't belong yes. to us, or pronouns that do not, suit us. So it's the same kind of discomfort that they have to go through. Unfortunately, in this case, even after a thorough psychiatric evaluation, after proper treatment and everything, they went to an endocrinologist who wanted them to wait for another 6 months, because the endocrinologist wasn't sure that this person's gender is male. Now, even our law states, the Supreme Court says, the Transgender Act says that the gender of a person can only be determined by this person. Okay. It will not be certified by a doctor. We are nobody to say that this is somebody's gender. But unfortunately, they had to, face that sort of very unpleasant situation with a doctor who's supposed to be helping the patient. I spoke with the doctor, and there was absolutely no rationale behind their decision. So, of course, we found another endocrinologist who was more aware of transgender health okay. and what exactly needs to be done when. So that okay. saved a significant amount of mental trauma to the patient right. after going through so many waiting years.